I have one more presentation from the MMDA, which will be about 10 minutes long, and then we will begin with our questions, the senators here present. I'll have Senator Ralph Recto first, and then we will go with the by succession of our by order of arrival. MMDA.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Allow me to present our brief presentation on the condition of traffic here in Metro Manila. Our presentation is, of course, limited to Metro Manila conditions. And as what you said, Madam Chair, our presentation is data-driven. This is what is found in the roads. This is what the numbers are for us. We are, first and foremost, are the issues. We have been dwelling onto the issues with regard to congestion. This data tells a lot. The nationwide population density of the Philippines is 337 persons per square kilometer. In Metro Manila, it's 20,247 persons per square kilometer. That speaks a lot. And dito po sa Metro Manila, we have a total population of 12.9 million according to the 2015 census. But that is for nighttime. At daytime, it's 14.5 million. That means every day, more than a million come in and goes out in the afternoon in Metro Manila. What do they do here in Metro Manila? Nag-aaral po sila dito. Dito sila nag-aaral. Dito ang kanilang kabuhayan. Dito ang kanilang mga trabaho. So this would probably explain yung rush hour traffic po natin. Ganun po kadami ang pumapasok at lumalabas ng Metro Manila on a daily basis. More than a million. Second issue po natin is the behavior of drivers. We know for a fact na pag tayo ay nasa loob ng sasakyan, nag-iiba yung ating behavior towards other people. It would be entirely different kung face-to-face tayo. But if we are shielded by the armor of our vehicles, nag-iiba ho ang behavior ng mga drivers po natin dito sa Metro Manila. The third issue is high accident rates. We have a total of 262 accidents per day. Ito lang po yung recorded accidents per day dito sa Metro Manila. Why did we come up with this? Isang aksidente lang po sa daan, magkokos ng tremendous traffic. Bakit po nagtatagal at hindi natatanggal agad yung mga nagbungguan sa daan? Is one, hindi ho ino-honor ng ibang, for example, ng insurance ang investigation report na ginawa ng MMDA. It should be a traffic investigator from the Philippine National Police. The investigation report of the MMDA is also not accepted as evidence admissible in court. It should be the report of the Philippine National Police. So what happens? We have to wait, hindi ho gagalawin ng mga sasakyan until the police investigators come in order to sketch, to make a sketch and to make a report on the accident. And this would take time because na-traffic na nga yung buong daan, pati yung mga police para pumunta doon ay na-traffic na rin. Now, this is also telling, Madam Chairman, according to a JICA study, because Metro Manila has 636 square kilometers of land area, we should have a road network of around 8,295.7 kilometers. That's the total number, ideal number of road networks in Metro Manila. But what do we have right now? Our total road network is 5,220. So we lack 3,000 kilometers of road here in Metro Manila in order to service the metropolis. And what is 3,000 kilometers? That's the distance between Metro Manila and Tokyo. Ganun po kalaki ang pagkukulang natin sa road network. And of course, this is exacerbated by the high volume of vehicles. We have a total of 2.3 million registered motor vehicles in Metro Manila. And I emphasize the point, registered in Metro Manila. because you correlate that with my earlier slide on the number of people coming in and out of Metro Manila. Hindi lang ho sila pupunta dito na naglalakad. Nakasakay din po sila at yung mga dala nilang mga sasakyan ay probably not registered in Metro Manila. They're probably registered in Cavite, in Antipolo, in Bulacan, and they go to Metro Manila every day. So, yung 2.3 million registered motor vehicles in Metro Manila is illusory. Mas malaki pa po ito kumpara sa data na nakuha po natin sa LTO. So this is more than that. And we have to understand also, Madam Chairman, that car sales has been increasing tremendously. According to projections by for this year, car manufacturers are predicting a 30% increase. So by the end of the year, we might be having 3 million registered motor vehicles in Metro Manila. And the total number of registered motor vehicles in Metro Manila is 26% of the entire registered vehicles all over the country. Napakalaki po niyan compared to the area of Metro Manila. And because of that, look at our EDSA traffic. According to a study, EDSA has a capacity of 6,000 vehicles per direction per hour. That means yung 6,000 pong vehicle, ilagay nyo lahat sa EDSA, for 1 hour, puno po yung EDSA. But what are we having? We have 6,800 actual motor vehicles per direction per hour in EDSA right now. But what is more alarming, Madam Chair, because I asked the Traffic Engineering Center Director of MMDA to conduct another volume count in Metro Manila, and she did a motor vehicle volume count on July 27 of this year. And that number of 6,800 has increased to 7,500 vehicles per direction per hour. For a capacity of 6,000, according to international standards, traffic standards, you should have an 80% optimum number of vehicles. So 6,000 is already full. So you, in order for traffic to move, you should only have 5,600 vehicles for EDSA per hour per direction. But right now, last July 27, we recorded 7,500 vehicles per direction per hour in EDSA. For one direction, Madam Chairman. Yes. Per direction. So 1 hour, one direction is 6,000. The other direction is another 6,000 at any given time. So that is the gravity of the traffic congestion in Metro Manila. And of course, the initial steps that we did, and this is along the proposals of the Department of Transportation, is to take away provincial buses along the major streets of Metro Manila, and we have already initiated that by constructing the Southwest Integrated Provincial Terminal. This is the terminal which services provincial buses coming from Cavite and four provinces of Batangas. Ito po yung nanggagaling sa Coastal Road. We were not able to catch yung nanggagaling po ng South Luzon Expressway because this is another route, and those provincial buses coming from the NLEX. Ito po yung tatlong major entry points ng Metro Manila. The NLEX, the SLEX, and the Cavitex. We were only able to capture Cavitex with the construction of the Southwest Integrated Provincial Terminal. And the Department of Transportation is now constructing the permanent Southwest Provincial Terminal, which would take the place of our temporary terminal, which the MMDA is now operating. What are the issues and concerns that we have? First, presence of road right-of-way obstructions, particularly illegally parked motor vehicles and illegal vendors. Dito po pumapasok yung operability natin with the LGUs. Sometimes we we operate against these obstructions, but unfortunately, we are confronted with justifications coming from the local government units. For example, ordinances allowing parking along some roads, permits granted to vendors to ply their wares along the roads, and these are also, there are so many events like burol po ng mga kamag-anak ng barangay chairman, yung mga may party bigla sa daan. So these are the issues that we are facing in so far as illegal parking and traffic obstruction is concerned. As I said, we've launched several programs along this line, one of which is our out-of-line and anti-colorum drive. We have a total of 13,718 colorum vehicles that were apprehended. And ano hong problema natin dito is because kayang-kaya nilang tubusin yung mga vehicles na ito. And siguro what we need is a permanent, pag na-charge na po kayo maraming beses na nahuli kay colorum, you should not be able to fly. Yung vehicle na yun, hindi na siguro pwedeng gamitin sa kahit anong paraan. We have also initiated the anti-illegal parking operations, and this number is telling. For the month of July alone this year, we were able to impound 1,006 vehicles, illegally parked vehicles. This is banned by one team of the MMDA, isang team lang po ito. And we issued ticket violations for another 1,500. Ito po yung mga pagdating natin, walang driver, tapos biglang darating, titikitan na lang namin because we are not allowed to impound vehicles that are not abandoned. That means within 5 minutes, the driver appears, we just issue a ticket, we will not impound the vehicle. 2,506 for the month of July by one team is a big number. What more if we have more teams? What more if the local government units would join us in this anti-illegal parking operations? Another success story, Madam Chairman, is our no physical contact traffic apprehension policy. This addresses the behavior of drivers. We would like them to be very worried that although no traffic constable or no HPG is along the road, there are CCTVs watching them. And we are able to apprehend from April 15 to August 9, 2016, a total of 24,762 violations. What is our issue here? Our traffic fines are so low. They range from 150 to 300 pesos that it is even costlier for us to send the summons and the tickets to them than the traffic fines that we receive. Finally, Madam Chairman, in order to alleviate traffic, we have launched our Pasig Ferry system. This is an alternate mode of transport and it is welcomed by everyone. What are the issues that we are facing with our Pasig Ferry system? We have so many passengers, Madam Chairman. We lack the boats, so maybe this is the procurement issue. We cannot promote our Pasig River Ferry because we are afraid that we might be creating a long queue within our Pasig Ferry stations. We just lack the boats. And there is another challenge with regard to our Pasig River Ferry system, Madam Chairman. Once the passengers get out of the boat, they do not have any public utility vehicle for their last mile. They have to walk because our Pasig ferries are located along the Pasig River and there are no public utility vehicles servicing that part of the road. So, Madam Chairman, these are the issues that we are presenting right now in a short briefing coming from MMDA. Thank you, Madam Chairman.